Hey everyone, Spazz here. This is the Wii U gamepad, one of many accessories for Nintendo's latest home video game console. Longtime viewers will know where I'm going with this. But in case you're new to my videos,
I don't
really
need physical manifestations!
I have a history with the Wii accessories. But can you blame me? The Wii Remote may not have a full range of motion, but it's capable of emulating whatever simple task the games require. Playing a racing game? Turn it to the side and pretend you're holding a steering wheel. What about a first-person shooter? Use the B button as the trigger. But there were some companies, including the Big N, who deemed the human imagination incapable of performing such duties. They were convinced our primitive minds needed a sort of connecting tissue to, as I have previously stated,
further enhance the experience.
Thus, the great flood of Uff Pops began. And just what is an Uff Pop? But this is a new-ish system. So let's try to look at the new-ish accessories from a positive angle. Even though this is the first widely panned Nintendo console in about 20 years. Pray for me. But before we check out the new hotness, let us revisit the old, but not so busted. Due to its backwards compatibility, the Wiimote, Nunchuck, Classic Controller, and Balance Board all work on the Wii U. In fact, the Wiimote is essentially the system's main controller, meaning all of these are compatible as well. The same cannot be said for the GameCube accessories, sadly. Even though there are a few games that do support them, the Wii U wasn't designed with any of the proper controller. Ugh. Damn it, Nintendo! Stop announcing things after I finish my scripts! Anyway, let us delve into the reason why this next-gen console exists in the first place. Oh, you think I'm kidding? Well, allow me to blow your minds. Shortly after the release of Wii Sports Resort, software developers Yoshikazu Yamashita and Takeyuki Shimamura started working on ways to build on what was then the new Wii Motion Plus. One such experiment involved syncing the actions taking place on a TV with a monitor mounted on the Wii Zapper. Not only did this lead to the inclusion of a gyroscope in the 3DS toward the end of its development, but the beginning of two-screen gameplay. And after a few tweaks in the design, it was unveiled at E3 2011. To much confusion.
What the f***?
Now, I won't be going into too much detail on how it works. Apparently some gem-hoarding marsupial beat me to it. But if the 3DS is Nintendo's smartphone, then the gamepad is most certainly their tablet. It's a pretty neat piece of tech, and I'd love to see what else they can do with it. Without smothering it in Uff Pops. Though that would be a cool way to bring it full circle. And if they remade Duck Hunt, but anyway. Next up is the Wii U Pro Controller. Essentially, it's a fully wireless Classic Controller Pro. However, its downside is that it works for Wii U games and Wii U games only. And it looks a little too much like an Xbox 360 controller. Yeah, I won't judge. But it was nice of them to offer some variety to match an equally impressive lineup of launch titles. Including the one that turned the system into a glorified karaoke machine. Now, I'm not against singing games. This one's more unique just in the way it utilizes the gamepad. But Nintendo packaged it with their own microphone. What's so special about it? How is this in any way different? It isn't. It's just like any other dynamic USB microphone. Probably why it went on clearance. Speaking of bargains... When Nintendo released the latest installment in their fitness franchise as a trial download, the full version was yours for the low, low price of $19.95. If you purchased the Wii Fit U meter. Basically a glorified pedometer that syncs with the game and tracks your progress. Sorta like the Pokewalker. Geodude? Only more insulting.
Called me fat.
Okay, on to the Uff Pops. Fortunately, because this console is still fairly young, it doesn't have nearly as many as the Wii did in the same time span. But those weren't nearly as deceptive. For example, the accessory that came with Wii Party U.
The other accessory, smartass.
On the surface, this may seem stupid or even redundant, as the gamepad can lay perfectly flat on it, so or not.
Forgot it. Tilted. Like that.
See? Deceptive. But that's a good thing. That's progressive. But that's fine, because the rest of the F-Pops came with the system. Let's cover the ones that pertain to the gamepad first. Much like the 3DS, it too has a charging cradle. This is convenient for gamers who don't like too many exposed wires. Plus, it doubles as a stand in case you actually use the Wii U chat feature. But if my experience lends any credence to this item's frailty... it's a good thing I have a backup. The gamepad stand is... another piece of molded plastic designed to keep the controller propped up. But I've saved the best for last. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the Wii U system stands! Okay, I need to explain something.
Every piece of advertising I've seen for this showcases the system lying down flat. So why would they bother including these stands if they have a recommended way to display the hardware? Furthermore, why are there two stands for the gamepad when one is far more functional than the other? Why is there even a charging dock when there's a perfectly fine AC adapter in the box?
I'll tell you. Because the Wii U truly is progressive. Sorry to disappoint you, but there's really nothing wrong with these. They're not so much useless pieces of plastic, but useful pieces of plastic. I even keep the acronym.
Sure, I may not have any use for most of them, but that doesn't mean nobody else will. All of these have been designed to suit all preferences. You don't have to use the gamepad to play New Mario U. You don't have to lay the system down if you're short on space. You don't have to watch an old sitemate gain millions of subs and cry yourself to sleep because you know you lack the charisma and knowledge to reach those numbers.
Or maybe I'm trying to get MatPat to watch this video, but point is, this system is all about variety. It may not have a sporting chance now, but it has all the options for when it does. And that's all the accessories that I can think of. Unless I missed one. Pretty sure I didn't.
Hey, honey, what's this poster doing here?
Poster? What are you...
To be continued!
That doesn't answer my question.
Hey guys, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. But hey, there are ways that you can make your enjoyment known. One is by clicking the like button down there, and the other is leaving a comment. I know it can be a little harrowing sometimes, but hey, at least this isn't 4chan. I hope. And hey, if you're a little curious to find out what the whole To Be Continued was all about, by all means, hit the subscribe button and find out. Also on the screen, you'll find links to my last video, which was on Five Nights at Freddy's, and also a link to the playlist for the show that my wife and I do called Monster Vlogs, where we watch all the Universal Monster movies and talk about them. But are you the kind of person who wants to show their support just a little bit more? Well, then hop on over to my Patreon page and leave a couple bucks there. Every little bit helps, and... hey, you could still see the videos for free even if you don't. So, there you go. It's a win-win for everybody. Again, thank you so much for watching this video. The next one... you know what? I'm not even gonna make any promises. It's just gonna appear. Cause magic. It's what makes the world go round. Alright. See you guys later. Thank you!